Hello, my lovely Gemini. It is time to do a August reading. So we are going to look into what's going to happen for you in August. Remember, you can be Gemini, you can have Gemini wherever in your chart, you can be dealing with a Gemini, you can be a cross watcher. I am going to go through channeled messages first and whatever information you need when it comes to the planets around you. I do feel that a lot of you are trying to find your calm in a new way. I do feel that there is a new opportunity waiting for you, but you might not see it clearly at this moment. There's this message of looking closer. Like, for some reason, it's right in front of you, but still you are not really seeing it. This could be, how to solve a problem. This could be many things. I do see that there has been relationship fights in the past 5 months. This can also be with an ex, doesn't have to be someone that you are in a relationship with now or someone that you are married with. This can also be an ex. And you normally, as an air sign, choose to keep things on the light side. And you always have this tendency that you want to make things better for the other person in this situation. Like you want things to be fair. But when I did more channeling, I did hear the word powerless and tired. So I do feel that you're learning to actually stand up for yourself and not fighting for something that's not worth fighting for. I just saw 313, so that might be a sign in that combination. You really do need to take your power back. And by the end of the month, I do feel like you're going to find a more deeper and meaningful connection. There is a lot of focus on your emotions this month. Your guides are really, asking you to let go of the emotional baggage. It's time. It almost feels like you might even, step away from work, education, a project for a while to focus on issues around you. And I do feel that the issues are more based on a relationship. This can be with someone that you are together with or someone that you have been together with, so an ex. It can also be something with domestic issues. This can be something about custody. Emotional stability is really in the focus for you in August. You are going to be more drawn to academic and spiritual activities, spiritual guidance, your mental faculties, and your communication skills will be powered up if you take those steps. You're really going to tap into new energy, like the energy of the five realm. I do feel like it's because that it's actually preparing you for something major in your life. So there is a major shift happening, and it's right in front of you, but for some reason you're not seeing it. But I do feel it's because that your focus is on some kind of domestic issue or, again, fight with an ex or someone that you are in a relationship with. It's taking over a little bit, and you're really being pushed out right now to focus on that so that it can be resolved, so that you can move on. If you're single, you might look for financial prosperity. The message here, if this is you, is to look for other aspects in someone else. And I do feel for you, love can be found in your social contacts. So that is also a hint. Venus is really pushing relationships forward during the first week of the month. So again, the universe is trying to force you into something new. I am going to start out with taking a card from this deck, so that we can get some energy for you. I just saw 717. So many signs. Let's see if this makes sense. We do have take action and schedule yourself in, which makes sense with what we just went through. I do want to see if there is something else. Oh, there was something else. Ocean Jasper. Maybe that is like a hint and the red jasper, I mean, I do feel like you are working with your base chakra, which is about stability. You are. And the ocean jasper. Oh! I just realized that you have 2x jasper. That's actually interesting. The next one you have is carnelian. So there is a lot of reds in this. Feed your creativity. Feed your creativity. Very important. I did hear it's important to do the steps before moving forward. It's important to do the steps before moving forward. If you are losing motivation, I do feel you need to do checkups with yourself. Because again, there's something that you need to realize here. There's something that's holding you back. And again, I do feel it's something like either it's family matters or it's something that's right in front of you, like relationship. With that, let's take some cards from this deck to see what else is coming your way. I just saw Joy and Stability, which is the Four of Wands in the normal tarot. So there was this message of you moving into a more deeper relationship, commitment with a person. It might be someone that you know. It might be someone who's close, because we have this, that, you know, you can find love in your social contacts. So this could be someone that you have on your Instagram, someone that you have on your Facebook. So look closer. Someone that you have, you know, again, in your contacts on your phone. Okay, let's see. Whoa, that was a flying one. Ah, Six of Cups, simple love. Maybe you're healing something from the past. Seek, letting go of a Virgo. Or you need to come out of hiding, because this is the Virgo card in the normal tarot. Take the time to meditate. There might be something visions here. At the bottom of the deck, I did see the crown chakra. So yeah, higher faculties, it makes sense. There's a message for you here. There is a message for you. It really makes sense. The camera is blinking, so if it just stops recording and dying, I'm going to change the battery. For some of you, I do feel that the past is going to come back to help you, actually. This can be something with memory. It can be someone from your past who's trying to tell you, like, I see that this is not working for you. I see that you're hurting. Like someone who's trying to give you a push to realize something. It says 12-12. But it can also be a soulmate who's being, you know, put on your path. And like your higher self knows, it's for you to cheer up, not being so like stuck. And no matter what you have been going through, it is going to improve now. But you also have to see it. Is it worth going back to something that's not working? If you are dealing with a Virgo, I do feel you're going to leave that person. It doesn't have to be a Virgo, but it can be whoever. But it's something that's not working. This can also be old mentality, old paradigm, the way that you're thinking. Again, higher faculties. It's time for you to think bigger, seeing a higher perspective here. You might feel lonely, there might be, you know, paranoia in this. Like, maybe you are very, you know, like, you don't trust easily if there's someone else coming into your life. But I do feel like your higher self is trying to make you aware that there is someone who's close. Someone that you recognize, but that you maybe ignore the signs. Obviously, this can also be with the work, but I do feel that it is emotional healing for you. With the crown chakra, it's all about thought. It's all about I know. So I do feel you know. You know what you need to do here. And you can open up your third third party. Well, okay. You can open... Well, I'm sorry, guys, I've been dealing with a third party. You can open up your third... Why do I want to say third? Maybe some of you guys are involved in a third party situation. But what I wanted to say, if Spirit wants to let me say it, you can open up your crown chakra by visualizing a lotus flower, blossom from the top of your head. It's all about spiritual awareness. And you are being called into this now. There is no time to waste anymore. Also with us moving into this like Aquarius energy again. It's higher awareness. I do feel that these cards just popped up. Some of you guys might be afraid to leave a situation for some reason. Relationship, or it's like staying put in an old job. In a place that you don't feel like you belong anymore. House, home, country, city. Like there's nothing there for you anymore. But for some reason you're still keeping yourself locked in it. Like you don't feel worthy. You feel like you have been going through so much that you can't handle anymore. You need to leave this. Let's see what else we can get for Gemini for... August. Ooh, yes. You are moving forward. You are healing. Also now that I do feel that again, there is a hint when it comes to the past that's actually coming in to help you. And I do feel some of you guys are healing loneliness. You are healing a relationship that made you lonely or a relationship that's still making you lonely. Can also be healing from a relationship with a Virgo. Can be. Let's see what else we can get for you. What else can we get for Gemini? What else can we get for Gemini? Someone said, close your eyes and think. Close your eyes and think. Make sure to close your eyes and think. Makes sense with these two cards. Yeah. I do feel some of you guys are even moving. Moving. Yeah. But I don't know why you're struggling with the, you know... You're struggling when it comes to believing in something. You do have to believe in this. You do have to believe in this. Yeah. I don't know if some of you guys are tied down with a person when it comes to finances. But you have to trust that there is a new beginning. Sometimes we do need to... leave a situation and then the universe is going to give us the next. I feel like that's what's actually happening for you. You need to trust what's happening. Oh my god, yes. You are leaving. Yes, you are. You are moving away. You are leaving a bad situation. You're being called to actually physically move. The moment you make up your mind and you move, the big shift is happening. Like, you're being offered a big chance here. A big change. Take action. Take action and move forward. But you do need to end something or leave something before this can happen. Go after adventure. Go after the new. Find your creativity, because there's a lot of creativity in this. I am going to give you the last message. Oh, that actually made sense. Detachment. Oh my god. Some of you guys might have been humiliated by someone. Who did this to you? Detachment. You are releasing old patterns and ideas that no longer serve your highest idea of love. You are. That's why we have this. Humiliation. Humility. Well, I did say humiliation, so. You have developed the loving awareness that you and everyone else are the same, but on a different path. Humility. Well, I did say humiliation, so I do feel that some of you guys have been dealing with something, someone who was very nasty. Also because we do have respect here. You value everyone's unique perspective on the path of love. And it's also the message in the beginning, like, the past 5 months you have had a fight with someone and you have respected that person so much that you might have just let this person humiliate you. I am going to say it because that's what comes up all the time. I do feel there was a poor decision here, like the decision to stay in something that didn't work out. Maybe some of you guys stayed in something because of kids, but it's not working anymore. You do need to take the step now. Now is the time to take the step. I do feel this is everything for you guys for today. Let me know if this resonated. If you are in need of a private reading, healing session or removal of blocks, all information is down below on my website. Thank you guys so much for watching and being a part of this channel. I'm really grateful for all of the likes and the comments. But I do feel this is going to be it. Remember to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Out of ourselves, can you feel it? Almost like I don't know if it's real, cause when we're doing our thing, we're like wheels that won't stop turning. So take me on a trip.